Worldwide, the toll of death is probably about 700,000 people a year from antibiotic resistance. So resistance is really a much more serious problem than most people understand. Resistance is an inevitable biological process. There is no getting away from it. But there's also no getting away from the reality that we made it much worse. There's a certain percentage of the prescriptions written by doctors' offices that aren't actually doing anything. We vastly misuse antibiotics in agriculture. When we take antibiotics, or when animals take antibiotics, there's a certain percentage of them that our bodies don't use, so they pass out of us. And so there's raw antibiotic floating around in our environment. Bacteria start to evolve defenses against these antibiotics that are based on their natural weapons. And those defenses are what we call antibiotic resistance. So what happens is that bacteria learn to defend themselves against the first generation of antibiotics, and so then we get a second generation. They do the same thing and we get a third generation. Where we are now is not just that the bug's defenses have gotten extremely elaborate and complicated, but also that we have no new drugs. A scientist named Adam Roberts had the idea that maybe one of the solutions to the problem of antibiotic resistance was to go back to the way that we found antibiotics at the very beginning of the antibiotic era, which is looking around in the environment instead of in a lab. What's different about what he's doing is that he has a crowdsourcing campaign. He asks people to look around their environments, the boles of trees, the dirt under a garbage pail, their dog's nose, their desk, their keyboard. He's gotten some really nasty stuff off cell phones. He asks them to swab them and to send them to him. He takes the swab. Then really what we think of as the modern scientific world comes in, and he can take those compounds and put them through a whole bunch of assays using much more sophisticated tools. And he is actually finding new compounds that might not solve the problem, because this is an endless battle, we're never going to solve it, but will help slow the problem down by giving us new treatments.